Hi, Kate Floss Live, citizen reporter, citizen lawyer from Bangkok, fighting for the Commonwealth and fighting from New Zealand for the Commonwealth. Now we hear news, everybody, that there's a bit of an echo here in my apartment. It's empty, there's no furniture. Never mind. There's news that the Majesty has cancelled the Christmas party, the family Christmas party. There are things going on. Now this 1688 Bill of Rights has got some very important, clauses that you all need to understand. That one of the clauses is that no foreigners can govern in your country. That is the main clause. Another clause is the other clause that is very important in the 1688 Bill of Rights is the non-obstant clause. Now, the non-obstant clause is the most difficult clause to understand in the whole 1688 Bill of Rights, because the liberties to be allowed forces all ministers, all government officials, and even the monarch herself to uphold our rights. But the non-obstant clause is the holy grail. The non-obstant clause means that usually in law, governments, prime ministers, queens, they can change laws that can be inconsistent with other laws. They're allowed to do it if they want to. But the non-obstant law forbids that to happen in regards to the 1688 Bill of Rights. So no queen, no king, no government, no prime minister, no police officer is allowed to change any of the rights in the 1688 Bill of Rights. Now this non-obstant clause is causing problems for the global corporation and for the New World Order. Because what it means is that every time they try to make laws, their laws are knocked back, especially when it is laws in regards to their global government. Their laws are knocked back because of the non-obstant clause and also the clause that says no foreigners are allowed to govern in our countries. So this whole thing that's going on in our countries, it's to bring down the Commonwealth. They're bringing down the Commonwealth and they want the non-obstant clause gone, because they can't change anything in that 1688 Bill of Rights as long as the non-obstant clause is there. Now, when you go and read it, you won't understand it. You've got to go and Google the non-obstant clause and see what it means. And there's several meanings, but one of the main meanings is that the monarch has the right to override any government laws that she wants to. But the non-obstant clause forbids her from overriding any of the rights in our 1688. Now, that I told you that this 1688 Bill of Rights, we're not so interested in all the rights. The main thing that we're interested with this global takeover of our countries, the main rights that we are interested in is, one, liberties to be allowed. In this clause, all ministers, all governments, everybody have to follow the rule of the people of this 1688 Bill of Rights. So that is the main one. The second one, the hugest one in our protection from this global takeover, is the forbiddance of foreigners or other states or religious leaders from having any power or any authority in any of our Commonwealth countries. So these, they want these two laws gone. And then the last one is the non-obstant law, which forbids any corporation, any government, any king or any queen from changing these laws. So you must get a copy of your 1688 Bill of Rights. Now, the way that these corporations, it hurts my hand, the way that these corporations have got planned to rid us of our non-obstant clause and our liberties to be allowed and the forbiddance of their corporate governance over our countries, the way that they're going to do it is, this is actually a will that was left to us in 1688 by the people of the time. They made this will. And what they're going to do is get the will away and out of the way for their new world order to completely evolve. You can't just take a will out of its power, especially because of the non-obstant clause. You can't do that. But what you've got to do is get, you've got to create a new will and a new trust, which is the Who Man's Rights Act. And every time that you file a case using the Who Man's Rights Act or the 1990 New Zealand Bill of Rights or the Australian Bill of Rights or the English Bill of Rights, every time you do that, you are making a disclaimer to the will of the 1688, your true and ancient rights. And if enough people do that, then what they can say is that we have disclaimed the will of the Majesty. Who is the Majesty? We are. We are. It is the Majesty, the Queen. The Majesty is us, and the Queen holds us up high above man-made laws. And we use the non-obstant clause to do this because it is the blocker for any man-made laws to infringe or to override any of our rights. And there are many rights in there, you can use many of them. But like for this COVID thing, you can use your cruel and unusual punishment. You can use excessive fines when they're forbidding you from going out of your house. That comes under excessive fines without conviction. You can use all of that. This is higher than the Health Act. It's higher than any laws in your country. It's higher than the Pope. Even the Pope has no power over the non-obstant clause. And that's because at the beginning of it, it tells who wrote this 1688 Bill of Rights. Lords Spiritual. That was all the popes, all the Jewish leaders, all the English archbishops got together and realized that the barbarous religions were destroying us. They were murdering us. They were stringing us up, burning our people. And these religious leaders, even the Catholics, all of the religious leaders got together, and that's Lords Spiritual. And then they had Lords Temporal. Lords Temporal are the kings, the queens, the barons, the knights. They all signed up to this will. And the other one is the commoners, which was us. So there was huge, huge meetings with all of the religious leaders, all of the kings and queens in France and England, Scotland, Ireland, and included the people as well. And they made a will for us, and to stop future generations from removing this will, they put in the non-obstant clause. And the non-obstant clause is the blocker to all of these corporations. But why isn't it working at the moment? Why isn't it having any effect in our lives? Because we are not claiming. The Queen has no power. Nobody has any power to force you to use this Bill of Rights. You've got to start going to the court and claiming your right under the 1688 Bill of Rights. When you've had a problem at the protest and they've forced you to go home, go and use your cruel and unusual punishment law. Go and use your excessive fines without conviction. Excessive fine, excessive bail without conviction is not only talking about money. That can be that you're locked in your house. That can be that you're forbidden to go and buy food at the supermarket. That can mean that you're forbidden to make social contact, to open your church. All of that comes under excessive bail without conviction, because there's been no conviction and they are ordering you to do it. And you're doing it. You're doing it. When this happens, you still have to comply. I'm not telling you not to comply. You must comply with what they say because you haven't filed your claim yet. But you do what they say. If they say stay in your house, then you stay in your house. If they say no protest, then don't have a protest. But then you all go to the court and you make your claim to your ancient rights. That's what you're not doing wrong. This is what you're doing wrong. You're using the human rights, which are not your rights. These rights are for refugees and immigrants. Your rights, you're born with them. No man-made law can make it for you. Now get in there, print yourself a copy of the 1688 Bill of Rights. Read the non-obstant clause, study the non-obstant clause. Read the liberties to be allowed that the ministers must kneel to you. Study it. Read your excessive bail. Study it. And get down to the courts and make your claim. Make your claim. That's all I'm going to say to you. Oh, there's a big court case. We're going to make our first claim on Monday. So me and Curry Campbell, we're going down to the courts and we're going to be making our first claim for our ancient and inductible rights on, I'm not going to say Monday because I'm just going to say next week, we're going to make our claim. You all need to make your claim. And this will all go away. Make your claim. Use the will that was given to all of us 400 years ago. It's called the will of God. Use it. God save the Queen. How can I sing the song to the Queen? I forgot the Queen's song. Right, there you go. That's it. Kate Floss, citizen journalist, citizen lawyer, signing out from Bangkok, Thailand, fighting for the Commonwealth.